Hi everybody. It's me, Lisa T, coming at you with a reading from The Language of Letting Go, my Melody Beatty. Changing it up here today. I usually like get all fussy and I have to set the camera up perfectly and I gotta try and, you know, look presentable and I put all this pressure on myself. So today we're just on the couch, chilling out with me. Just you and me chilling out on the couch, reading Melody Beatty. So today is February 22nd, solving problems. Starts off with a little prayer. So I ask, and you shall receive. I ask that you might help me work through all of my problems to your glory and your honor. I ask that you may help me work through all of my problems to your glory and to your honor. Work through my problems to your glory and your honor. Work through my problems to your glory. I guess because I'm just trying to figure out like what that means for me. So for me, that means by working through my problems, the more problems I solve, the more success I have. And the more success I have, the more I can share. And as I work through problems, if I share that, then I can help someone else. So that's helping others and that's doing the will of the world. Yeah? The will of God? I don't know. Okay. So here we go. I had somebody watching and then they popped off. Ooh, my ego. Ouch. Watching? Nah, moving on. Okay. Many of us lived in situations where it wasn't okay to identify, have, or talk about problems. So they're talking about childhood. Denial became a way of life, our way of dealing with problems. Denying them became a way of life. Denying everything, denying problems, denying we have pain, denying we're in fear, denying we're hurt, became just a way of life and then became a habit and became the way we live. In recovery, many of us still fear problems. We may spend more time reacting to a problem than we do solving it. So we waste time and energy reacting instead of looking for a solution to solve the problem. And again, the more problems I solve, the more success I have. That doesn't mean, please, universe, God, that does not mean I want more problems. I've had enough already. I just say, be careful what you're working on because you're going to get examples to work on it. Okay, so we may spend more time reacting to a problem than we do solving it. We miss the point. We miss the lesson and we miss the gift. Problems are a gift. Everything's a gift. It's all a gift. Especially because it's all happening in the present moment. So we miss the gift. Problems are a part of life and so are solutions. So it's the yin and the yang, the black and the white. Yes, we're going to have problems. But guess what? If we have problems, we also have solutions. So there's the good news. That's the silver lining. There are solutions. Let's find them. Let's create them. Let's make them. Let's solve with solutions and let's gain success. So a problem doesn't mean that life is negative or horrible. Just because you have a problem doesn't mean that something is wrong with you or with your life or that there's some negative situation. Man, we got to flip our thinking around everything. Having a problem doesn't mean that a person is deficient. All people have problems to work through. Well, you're not alone. Everybody's got something they're working through. In recovery, we learn to focus on solving our problems. First, we make certain that the problem is our problem. And that was back a few readings ago. Make sure it's your stuff and not someone else's. So make sure that the problem is our problem. If it isn't, our problem then is establishing a boundary, or the solution is establishing a boundary. Then we seek the best solution. This may mean setting a goal, asking for help, big one, highlight, asking for help, gathering more information, taking an action, or letting go. And I just want to highlight that asking for help too. That's brave. That's brave. That's responsible. That is not weakness, that is strength when you ask for help. If you're someone who doesn't ask for help, please start asking for help because it's a sign of strength. It's a sign of knowing yourself and your limits and it's a sign of being able to be brave enough to reach out for help and know that you're not perfect. It's brave to reach for help. Recovery does not mean immunity or exemption from problems. Recovery means learning to face it, deal with it, heal it, right? That's what they keep saying. So recovery means learning to face and solve your problems, becoming powerful and strong and successful, knowing that they will appear regularly. That's life. Things are going to come up. It's a part of life. So we can trust our ability to solve our problems and know we're not doing it alone. Please don't do anything alone. Having problems does not mean our higher power is picking on us. It means he's working on us. You're getting attention paid to you. Some problems are part of life. Others are ours to solve and will grow in necessary ways in the process. Face and solve today's problems. Don't worry needlessly about tomorrow's problems, because when they appear, we'll have the resources necessary to solve them. So do what you can today so that tomorrow you are full of everything that you need to deal with tomorrow. And you're not still dealing with yesterday, right? Facing and solving problems, working through problems with help from a higher power means we're living and growing and reaping benefits. Yay! So here's your prayer for today. God, help me face and solve my problem today. Help me do my part and let the rest go. Yes, freeing. I can learn to be a problem solver. Yes, you can. For solving problems and becoming successful. That's all. Have a great morning, evening, and good night.